Attention viewer, you are watching the world's biggest Monster Truck Diecast YouTube channel. This is Monster Jam OCT.
Welcome back, everyone, to another Monster Jam OC review video. Today, we are looking at a preview of the Superstore exclusive for the Halloween season of 2020. And as you guys know, if you've been collecting for a while, you know that the Superstore, the MonsterJamSuperstore.com, has usually every year a Halloween truck for the celebration of Halloween. And as we know in the past, Hot Wheels has made four different Halloween trucks. One year, they did skip it over, but they did do them from, I think, 2014 through 2018. And one of those years was skipped. I believe it was 2017 that got skipped. But we do have those four here, as well as Spin Master's first Halloween truck from 2019, which was the Pirate's Cursed Ghost. As you can see, a quick recap, we have had the Gravedigger Pumpkin Edition, as I call it, with the pumpkins in the graveyard and the ghost with the pumpkin face. This is my favorite design, but I wish that Spin Master would redo it on the new tool with some updated graphics. So that's really cool. Gravedigger, I definitely think Spin Master should redo it, but we did have this one, I believe, in 2014. And then we had the pumpkin zombie. In the future, I think after we've done all different trucks, I think they should come back and redo these because they deserve some new toolings. But we have this pumpkin zombie, which glows in the dark. So the logo and the eyes and stuff will glow in the dark. And it was a pretty cool concept. And then we have the skeleton bull, or El Toro Loco, as people called it. It was Bulldozer because it looks like Bulldozer, but it is El Toro Loco, and it's just skeleton form of that. And then the most recent Hot Wheels and last one of their era was the Monster Mutt, which used the incorrect tooling, but it is the Mummy Monster Mutt. So you can see that's their last Halloween truck. And then we had the Pirate's Cursed Ghost, another glow-in-the-dark feature truck for the 2019 Spin Master Halloween truck. And I really enjoyed this one. These are still available currently, I believe, on the Monster Jam Superstore, but this video is coming out way later in the year. I'm recording this video in late May of 2020, so don't quote me on these. They might still be available, but it's possible that they're not at this point in time. But this is the Ghost Halloween truck for Pirate's Curse by Spin Master. And now in 2020, we have our second ever Halloween truck, and I want to thank my friends at Monster Jam and at Feld for sending this in for review, and also at Spin Master because they did help with this one. This is the next Halloween truck, and it is the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior Vampire. So they are taking the Mohawk Warrior truck and making it into another new style with a new tooling on the top. So you can see the Mohawk is a little different, and we'll get into that in just a moment. But I want to take a look at, up to this point in this video when I'm recording in May, these are the current Mohawk Warriors that we've had with different Mohawks. We've had the original one from 2019 with the backwards flowing Mohawk. We've had the Monster Jam Fire, or Team Fire edition, which we did see at All-Star Challenge, the real life truck and the toy version with the Fire Mohawk. And then we've had the 2020 corrected accurate Mohawk for Great Clips Mohawk Warrior. And now today we debut the third ever edition of Mohawk Warriors Mohawk, which is the Vampire edition. And as you guys probably know, if you know anything about vampires, they usually are paired up with bats or something in any kind of vampire movie or cartoon. So you can see that is a bat wing on his head instead of a mohawk, but in the shape of a mohawk. And then on the back here, you can see here's the little quote. You can read it, pause the video, and you can see the illustration. I'm sure it's by Neil Vandenberg, of the vampire mohawk warrior face. And then we have this quote here, Halloween Vampire Great Clips Mohawk Warrior, and limited edition, 1 of 5,000 units produced. And of course, our standard Superstore signup code. If you guys have not signed up before, you get 10% off your next purchase. And here's the front. I love the card illustration. The purple really changes up the dynamic that we've had going. So we've had a couple different colors on the cards, and they usually match their truck, but the purple is something brand new. I don't think they've done before in full purple, so it's really nice. And then you can see they're limited edition, 1 of up to 5,000 units produced. And there's the card insert, Halloween Great Clips Mohawk Warrior in red instead of purple with the vampire at the bottom. So this is also the first ever sponsorship truck that's become a Halloween truck. This has never been done before. Obviously, Gravedigger Zombie, El Toro Loco, and Monster Mutt, and Pirate's Curse are owned by Monster Jam, and so is Mohawk Warrior, but this is the first outward contract, like Great Clips contracting with them. So it's really nice to see them doing that. So let's open this up and check it out up close right now. So here is the truck. Here's the card art if you want to see what it looks like without the truck inside. And there it is. So that's the end of the box. Here is the insert with the Vampire Mohawk Warrior logo. It's a black insert card stand there. And then here is the Vampire Mohawk Warrior itself. What a nice piece. This is definitely something refreshing, something that I actually didn't even think of they would do as a truck for Halloween. I was expecting maybe next up something like Horsepower or Oxygenator or something. Actually, I would like to see a Max D Halloween truck or Son of a Digger, Bakugan Dragonoid, but this is the first Mohawk Warrior edition. It's really nice, again, like I said, to see something like this. And it's also the first SUV Halloween truck, so that's another little fun fact about it. So there's the Mohawk Warrior face in the vampire form with the red eye, the glowing red hue around it, which is a typical fashion about with the or around the normal Mohawk Warrior, which is purple usually. This one has that that red kind of glowing instead of the multiple lines around it. So that's pretty cool. And as you can see, it's usually yelling, but it's actually screaming instead of releasing those like waves of sound. It's releasing these bats. And they made the tribal, these little tribal pinstripes into bats as well. And then you have the moon in the background with this nice purple foggy haze, but it's pretty dark. So it's also really nice, a contrast to the red. And then we have a red Monstrum logo, the Great Clips Mohawk Warrior logo in the red form. And the hood here, which is fully wrapped in purple with the Foggy Night Sky Great Clips logo and the tribal pinstriping again as bats. The front grille is something I've complained about with the previous exclusives of the Superstore this year and other things that require it, like the Zombie Invasion series and Zombie vs. Hunters. I wish they would continue to do the headlight printing on special editions. It doesn't take away from them, it adds to the detail. And I get not putting a grille because you can see the detail of the fog, but the headlights definitely throw it off. So I hope that they'll continue to do headlights in future editions. But there it is right there, the front grille with the purple fog. And then we have a blood red roll cage, which appears to have, does have metallic inside of it, so glitter inside of it. That's pretty cool. And then the same goes for the rims, same exact color. They're almost semi-transparent. You can see kind of a translucent color red. And then a black chassis with dark gray tires. And there's the tailgate there, with the standard Mohawk Warrior version that we usually see on these. So that's pretty cool. And then the roof here, wrapping up there with the head. And then we have, of course, the centerpiece of this truck, which is the new tool Mohawk, which is the Batwing. So you can see this Batwing style Mohawk, which is solid plastic. It's very nice and very creative. This is just a really creative piece. They always do a really creative piece every Halloween. I'm really excited to see this one come out. So I can't wait to see what you guys think about it. If you guys want to order one, if this video is out, it's likely that they're already up for pre-order. So go check it out. Again, I'm recording this in early May, so I'm not sure what the timing of this is, but it is October. So happy Halloween season. Go check out your limited edition 1 of 5,000 on the Moss Jam Superstore. And I'm highly recommending this. This is such a cool piece. So thank you again to Moss Jam, my friends there and at Spin Master. And I will see you guys next time. This is Ryan or Moss Jam OCD signing out.